Greetings everyone, today I have a shopping my stash video. If you're a long time subscriber, you will remember I used to do these a really long time ago. A couple of years ago I stopped, and because I have been abroad, I had a very small collection of products, so I didn't really need to do a video like this. But since coming home, I've been reunited with a lot of the products that I left behind, and I'm kind of currently going through my products and getting rid of things because I just don't like clutter. It just clutters up my head, and I feel like it's a waste if something isn't being used. So my sister is going to be very lucky because she's got a lot of like my cast off makeup. So I've chosen some products today that I haven't used in a really long time or that I left behind when I moved abroad, and I just want to try and get some final use out of them, see how I feel, and if I like them then kind of incorporate them more, and if I don't, just get rid of them because what's the point. I chose a really small collection of items because I don't want to overwhelm myself. I feel like if I chose too many things, it will just kind of defeat the purpose of doing this. So just choose a small amount of things and then I know that I'll be able to rotate them and use them. So the first thing I have here, this is the MUA Heaven and Earth palette. I bought this before I left and I've probably used it like 3 times whilst I was abroad, but it's a really great neutral palette and you get really good payoff with some of the colours. I never really used it, but I think it's time to give this palette a go before I perhaps give it away, because I think I can create some really great neutral looks with this. I've been, as you can probably tell, well not today, but I usually like to do a very neutral eye and bold lip. It's a signature look, it's go-to, so I don't know why I haven't really reached for this more, but I'm gonna give this a go. I didn't go too wild on my choice of eyeshadow, so I only have 2 more choices here and they're both from MAC. So the first one here is Cork and the next one is Espresso. So I bought these a really, really long time ago when I was trying to build up my MAC collection, and I tried them probably a couple of times and I just didn't like how they looked on me because I feel like they're very cool tone and I'm very warm tone and it just made me look ashy and I didn't like that at all, so I just avoided using them. But to me, that's just a waste of money. Like, MAC eyeshadows are what, £14 a pop? I think out of the pan they're cheaper, but it's still freaking expensive for an eyeshadow to not use. So I really want to try and give these a go, so avoiding using them. And just try and incorporate them a bit more into my routine because I think it's just too expensive to not use and it's just a waste of money if I don't use them. So hopefully I'll find a use for them or find a way to incorporate them into my looks. Otherwise, they're going to be sold somehow. Next, I have an Illamasqua blush, which for some really strange reason doesn't have the name on it, but I'll probably find it and put it below. But this is just a purple blush. I've had it for a long time and I went through a phase where I loved this blush, but I left it behind when I moved abroad because I had another Illamasqua blush and it smashed. And I just think that the packaging is very flimsy on these. They don't travel very well, so I didn't want to bring it abroad with me and risk smashing another Illamasqua blush. But I really remember loving this blush, so I think I want to incorporate it a little bit more into my makeup routines because it's a beautiful colour and I don't think it should be neglected. Because I'm a blush fiend, I did allow myself to choose a few blushes because I love blush, so I know I will use those. So this one here is from Inglot and it is number 63. It is a beautiful fuchsia berry kind of blush. I bought it and I think I've probably used it once, if that. And I don't know why, I just never reached for it. It's so beautiful. I think it's because it's such a bright colour and I was worried that it would like clash with my makeup looks, but it's just too beautiful to neglect. So I'm going to try and incorporate this a bit more, maybe use a different kind of brush. I was going to say blush. Different kind of brush to apply it and hopefully it doesn't look too crazy on my cheeks. I have 2 blushes from the same brand. I have Sienna and I also have Mauve. They're both from La Femme. Do you guys remember there was a point in YouTube where everyone and their chihuahua was raving about La Femme blushes? I bought a bunch of them during that time and I just only pretty much use one like on a regular basis, which is Cinnabar. But in the spirit of trying new things or old things, trying old things, I have chosen these two because they're kind of polar opposites on the kind of blushes that I like using. So this one, Sienna, is kind of the neutral tone that I love using and it's a brownie blush, but it's a lot darker on my cheeks than I would anticipate and a lot more red as well. So I don't use it as much. And then there's also Mauve, which is a more pinky blush, and pink blushes are probably my least favourite, which is why I rarely use them, but hey, I'm trying stuff. So these are my choices. I have four lipsticks because I wanted to give myself some variation. That's what I'm telling myself. And the first one here is Vegas Vault by MAC. And I don't know, I bought this one and I don't think I really liked the shade after I tried it. It just was too bright on my lips and I didn't really know how to wear it. And at the time I bought it, I was kind of like, I avoided wearing lip liner for some really strange reason. I just didn't like wearing it. It was just too much work. I didn't like using it, so I just didn't use it. And so because of that, this just never looked good on my lips. And I have way more lip liners now and I experiment some with my lip liners, so now I think I will be able to make this work for me because otherwise it just looks a hot mess. So as it's like spring time, summer's coming, this one should be used during this time, otherwise it's a bit of a disservice. Next lipstick I have is from Rimmel London and this is Vintage Pink. Don't let the name fool you because it's more on the purplish side, which is right up my alley right now because I'm loving purplish toned lipsticks, which are really great for the spring weather we're having right now. And this one is a great transitional colour because it's not like a boom in your face purple. It's very muted, so I think it's a very wearable colour. Finally, again, I have two products that are from the same brand and these two are from Sephora. So the first one, the names have kind of rubbed off, so I'll have them linked below. But I think this one is, I don't know what this one is, but this is a pinky toned nude lipstick. And then the second one is, I know the name of this one, this is R19 because this one was my favourite lipstick of all history. For the longest time I have a backup of this lipstick, that's how much I loved it. And I just kind of fell out of love with them because again I didn't really use lip liners when I was wearing these, but I've learned my lesson. So I'm going to try and give these a go again because I've kind of neglected wearing nude lipsticks because I have just loved, you know, wearing the bright colours, having a pop on my lip excuse me, having a pop on my lip. And my nude lipsticks just kind of fell to the wayside, so I'm trying to get those used up now, so maybe I can make way for other lipsticks in my collection. But I'm gonna give these a go, maybe I'll fall back in love with these ones because these were definitely a huge favorite of mine for the longest time. So folks, those are the products I'm going to be shopping from my stash, and I'm most likely going to be doing a follow-up blog post on those products to see if I like them or if I'm going to be getting rid of them. So you can feel free to follow my blog, I will link it here and it's always linked below. Also, you can follow me on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook. Links are always below. I really hope you guys enjoyed that video, and I will see you guys next time. Bye!